one action.
Okay.
Swing that bat harder.
Nice.
Are you ready?
Whoa, baby.
Thank you. What would you do?
I don't know. I mean, I'll use 50-50.
Okay. We have 50-50 is that leads you down to two answers. Continue to put them on the table or take them away.
Take them away? And you've won! Table melt!
$1 million! Okay.
Hey, let's go.
Okay. Into the family room.
The family room.
Pepper started in there already.
And this is the useless junk market. See what? This is a picture of Aunt Jill and Scott's people we don't know.
Here's that useless junk market where you can buy any of this useless stuff that you want.
That's
and here's Tyler, and he's going to explain what each product is.
There's these CDs that I alphabetize. Ooh, there's a CD out of its case. Here's some weird movies. Here's some flowers.
Hold on, Ty. You're going ahead of me.
Here are these pumpkins. That when you throw them, they make a weird noise like this. Here are these expensive candles. Another pumpkin. Then we have these bowls. And these weird pebbles. People say they're real, but I don't
see this.
And then we have this picture of two people in a pumpkin patch. And this weird thing with the yellow submarine. And let's sing a song. We all live in the yellow submarine. A yellow submarine. We all live in a yellow submarine.
All right, let's go show the rest of the downstairs. Here we go. Here's the coat closet.
Ah!
Ah!
There's
someone
the coat
in
closet.
Our coat closet.
We're just gonna hang it out here.
And let's keep on going down the hallway. Coming into the bathroom.
This is where it all happens. This is the room right here. Our favorite room of the house. Oh my god!
There's someone in there too!
Oh, you like hanging out in that Chinese bathroom too, I see.
They close out this like Chinese stuff.
This is the bathroom that Brian and Tyler used when they were here this morning.
And there's some sort of story that's being told
on the
wallpaper. We just haven't been able to figure it out yet.
There is a story. We'll tell it to you next time.
Maybe Tali can help us figure it out.
Still going.
So we're leaving our favorite room and we're coming down the hall. This is the front. Oh! Oh my god, there's another person in here.
Oh my goodness!
Oh!
How can you be in every room?
This is the furnace room. Hot water heater, and when
storage.
Tyler causes trouble, we just throw him in there. So
yeah,
get in there, you troublemaker.
Okay.
Be quiet. Okay,
okay,
now we have
hopefully
a,
Tyler will come out.
Now we have a guest bedroom.
Oh!
God,
and
they keep scaring me.
This is where Pepper sleeps.
Oh, this is where Pepper slept last night?
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
You were in Pepper's bed. She must have been in your bed.
No.
This is the
good
guest
morning,
room.
World.
No,
good
that was
morning,
in Pepper's
world.
Bed. That was our bed.
Oh,
this
right.
Steps.
This is Pepper's bed.
That's why it's in the
this
good
is the
guest
morning
room. World. It's a nice
and
bed.
And it still smells like cat in here.
Oh, yeah. When Mimi came in and Pepper
say
and Mimi
Pepper.
Don't like
this
each other.
This is Pepper's
so
room.
It was a drastic freak out and everything. Let's go.
And then we'll look in the laundry room.
The laundry
room. In the laundry room. Nobody must be in there because the door's open.
We've got lots of toilet tissue here.
Yes, not lots of storage.
Lots
washer
of
and dryer.
Ah!
Oh my goodness.
No one else is in there. I think Tyler's somewhere else.
Tyler must be somewhere else.
Yeah. Forgetting someone.
Forgetting you. Okay, and then we'll take a peek in the garage.
Yeah.
and show you our garage. I think Pepper wants to go into the garage. And here's our garage. Uncle Scott's car and my car. Okay. And now we're going to go into the rec room. Thank you.
Wait up!
Aww, what's that on the ping pong table? Wait, sir.
There's me.
It's ping pong! I'm Fry and I'm
Hi, Mimi.
Ping pong, you ready? You ready, bro?
Ping pong, this is our rec room.
Let's go!
And some pro ping pong players. It's a little hard when you don't move that treadmill.
Just a little.
Let's go say hello to me. Okay.
I'm strong.
Wait, we should look in the office. Oh, let's watch Tyler lifting some weights.
Okay.
Ooh.
I'm feeling muscles. It's my turn to lift some weights.
We gotta get stuff in before intermission.
Okay, and to the office we go. Ooh, recording.
This was a nice office. It's got these two desks. You know, when you have no work, you can just, like, take a nap. Sing another song. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on his farm he had some pigs, E-I-E-I-O. With an oink oink here and an oink oink there, here and oink here and oink.
And this is our great big closet for storage. And
Everyone, E-I-E-I-O. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on his farm he had some pigs, E-I-E-I-E-I-O. To take the upstairs steps. Careful with your step, everyone. Narrow is narrow. Twirly, twirly. Twirly, twirly. Twisty, twisty. Oh, and look, there's our friend, good friend Mimi. Up here.
Hey, come on, Mimi, let's go.
Come
on.
Come on down.
We'll go up, we'll see
her.
We're
going
up. Hey, Mimi. Here, look up there at the camera.
Mimi.
Careful where you step.
Oh, she ran away.
Oh, and here's her green bed.
Wait,
hey, he's
not
stop. Here's her green bed.
Mimi, is that your bed?
Wait, and first step. Everyone stop for a second. This is my friend, Ratchie. He is your tour guide for the upstairs house.
What?
Ratchie speaking. What'd he say? He says he wants to see the rest of the house.
Let's go.
Let's go.
This one.
Well, first we look in here.
It's not the closet.
This is where you hide the Hanukkah presents.
Better take a look in here. Not that interesting, is it?
No.
Water heater closet.
Cool.
Okay.
And then we have this.
Another closet!
Another closet.
With the wrapping paper. And now it gets exciting. Because we are about to get to the room where we go. Name
that beetle! And for our first contestant is Tyler Dretch. Who is that beetle?
Picky beetle? Wrong! And that concludes the end of Name That Beetle!
No, it doesn't. We still have three more beetles to go. Try this one.
Stupid beetle.
Wrong! this beetle.
Crazy beetle?
No. And for the last, and last but not least, this beetle.
See. Ringo?
Right.
It is Ringo.
Woohoo! You, 1 for 4, not bad.
Okay, and now, to our next.
And he wins. What does he win?
Oh, tie
he wins
all
the tour of the rest of the upstairs.
I win this pet ratchet. Woo. A ratchet.
And
yeah, a ratchet.
The answers
yeah,
are
Paul.
Paul.
And now, a word from our sponsors. A word from our sponsors.
Hey, if you have a cat, and your cat doesn't know where to sleep, well, look at this. It's fabulous. It's only $5.95 plus taxes.
I need a bed. That bed looks good. Let's see.
And there's our perfect example. So buy your cat bed.
And it's only $5.95 with taxes.
So buy your cat bed at Z-Mart. And here, and look at our happy customer.
Smells
good. And that's my commercial.
Besides, it has so much stuff in it. You know how much stuff it is? It has like so much.
Let's,
you
know, you want to see how much?
Let's look. That's how much it has.
See, it has 1, 2, 3,
4 walls? All right.
4 walls and a roof.
And a roof. And a
floor. And look at this. And look at this little kitty.
And I can look myself in the mirror.
And here's one of our other customers.
A ratchet.
From
yeah,
the
yeah.
cat
a
bed.
Ratchet. Yeah, but we frizzed the cat.
But we
used
the
black.
Wait,
we just
wait, let's see that cat. What do you have there?
And here's another customer from our cat bed.
She will stay in the bed.
Only problem with her is she also slept in our latest bed. Freeze bed.
Hey, Mimi,
it
what are you doing to that carpet over there? Get on your scratching
ooh,
pad.
Freezing.
She's
okay.
Not
to the new bathroom.
And now the new bathroom.
Oh, I've heard about this bathroom.
Newly painted.
I heard that they brought in these workers from all the way across the Delaware River and some other state, Pennsylvania or something like that, and they brought them all the way over into New Jersey just to work on this bathroom.
Whoa!
Take wallpaper down and paint it. Wow!
I'm sitting on the toilet. I'm sitting on the toilet.
Do, 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 do.
Come on, look
let's here. Look at the amenities in this bathroom. Could you guys please explain to us what these three things represent here?
Okay.
Starting with the top left.
Okay. This is the sun flower. It represents the sun in not only a little flower.
And the butterfly?
This is a butterfly. It exposes all its glory. Isn't it pretty? It
and,
sort of,
and the third thing?
And this is a purple flower. It looks just like the fish in the sea.
Dance break! Do 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 do!
Hey!
Get back in your shower there. Oh, what a pretty bath shower. Aunt Jill must have picked that.
She must have.
Purple, my favorite color.
And what do we have over here?
Fishy
ooh,
outfit.
A little cat litter action.
Yeah.
Mimi's two dishes.
Yeah, look what's in it.
And we've got a night. When Mimi's bored, she jumps up on the windowsill here and she looks out. Oh, what a pretty view. Her favorite pumpkin
Mimi's
is out on the
now.
Lawn there.
Oh, and look, Mimi's here now.
Mimi's saying, what are you doing in my bathroom?
Mimi is not comfortable with this many people in here. She feels like we're violating her
I'm
area.
On the pie.
That's just too bad. And here's the sink. That's Mimi's Sun and Earth hand soap. And when she's thirsty, she just opens up the faucet there and gets some water. And then her other cat bed with her favorite purple toy.
Purple
Brian, can you tell us about that purple toy?
Well, this purple toy is very special. This purple
yes,
toy
it is.
This purple toy can dance.
There's a Grouchy.
And this purple invisible toy can also do a great imitation of us.
Oh, are we going to see a scratchy, itchy show, a ratchy purple animal show?
Ratchy purple animal show here.
Right. You want to see a rat? I do. Okay.
Okay, enough of that.
You've all been waiting for
the door of surprise.
Everything past here is surprising. So if you guess, there's no reason for it. See, look at this. There's a chandelier. You can shake it.
You can show the chandelier.
Don't wear
stained glass window.
Where?
Right there.
There's stained glass window in this house?
Right there.
Oh my god.
Can we quote this aunt on how she likes this?
Polly, do you know what kind of birds those are? When we see you, you're going to tell us what those birds are. And if you look over this way, you can see there's another window. Can you tell us what kind of bird that is?
Cardinal?
Shh.
Tyler gave you a big hint.
Did you hear Tyler's hint? If you didn't, you can tell us when you see us. And last night we played a game down there with a fire and listened to some music. And we marshmallow roasted.
Into the bedroom. Let's look to the right first. Lights on.
And we have some closets over here. Let's just see. This is Scott's closet. Let me show you some of my clothes. And
he wears me.
Oh my god.
He wears me. You can walk in this closet. It has a lot of utility closet.
Including these mouse traps that have to go up there because we think there's things scurrying around up there. We're going to send Brian and Tyler up there to find the mice for us.
No.
So then we're going out to Jill's closet. Do we really want to film that too? Okay.
And
let's see what we got in here. Oh my god, there's another set. Oh god, they're all over the place.
Hi, ho, she wears me.
And that was Michael's favorite spot where he likes to put on his plays. Hey, there's another cat in here. Oh, it's just me. This is where Michael puts on his plays. This is his stage area. And Brian and Tyler are going to put on their own play starting now.
Sorry, Ratchy.
Hey.
So we've got... Jill got some new colors in here. Heidi, I'm sure you'd appreciate this, but they're not out. So all you can see is our new bath mat, and in here we have another bath mat, and
pooping.
Oh Lord.
I'm cleaning my butt.
Hey, get off of our bidet.
I'm cleaning my butt.
Okay.
I'm pooping.
I don't think we need to see this one anymore.
I'm pooping.
Okay, and my favorite faucet's right there. And my other favorite faucet is right there. Can you show us how that works over there? Look how great this is.
This is a duck. The duck likes to spit.
All right.
And from the view from the bathroom, you can look outside and see Pepper by the pond.
Peppy. Oh, and what is Peppy doing? She's eating stuff she should not be eating. Is that bad? Here, knock on that window. Maybe she'll realize she shouldn't be doing
it. Here, open
this. Pepper! Well, let's go out there. Out on the thingy.
Here, we'll just open this.
No, guys, let's go on the window thingy.
Pepper!
Don't you eat that. Good girl. You listen to your master like you should.
Good girl.
Sit. Your master says sit.
And
of course she doesn't listen. Okay. Back on Mimi. Mimi doesn't understand what's going on.
And where are we going next?
And we're going
into
the palace of classical music.
Shh, I'm sleeping.
And this is the reason we actually bought this house. Wired throughout the house for musical enjoyment. And here we go.
Shh, I'm sleeping.
Jill's tired too. She's sleeping in the corner. and Brian and Tyler have just woken up, and Aunt Jill's woken up. Tali, say good morning to Aunt Jill. Aunt Jill, say good morning to Tali. And the twins want to take us out onto the deck. Is it open or is it locked? Okay, let's unlock it for you. How's the weather, guys?
Cold, sunny, 70 degrees.
Oh, there's a blue jay there, Tali. I heard you like birds. Let's see that bird just fly away.
Let's look for Pepper.
Okay, we're gonna look for Pepper.
I found Pepper. Let's go.
There she is. Pepper.
Oh, sweetie.
Peppy.
Hi, Beth. Hi, Beth.
What does it mean when a dog wags?
She must be happy.
And as you can see, the foliage is slowly ending as we proceed into the winter month. Okay, I'll stay here. Go down. And there's a blue jay. You see that thing flying there, Tali? That's a blue jay. And there's a lot of blue jays around here. There's a lot of cardinals. There's some doves. There's some finches.
There's fish.
Crows.
In the pond.
There's some fish in the pond.
Maybe we could feed the fish.
And we'll just kind of pan around for you. And here's Pepper again. Okay, let's see how good she is. Pepper, come here, Pep.
Is she going in?
No, I closed it.
Pepper.
Oh, somebody's
Pepper.
Coming out.
Pepper,
hey,
sit.
There's Brian.
Sit.
Pepper, sit.
Sit.
Here's
sit.
Our dog show.
Sit.
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 Nope. Okay, I guess it's not going to work. Okay, Brian, sit. Brian, sit. Oh, I say Brian sitting and it works.
Good girl.
Job.
Good boy.
Good girl. Okay, Brian, is there something you want to tell us down there?
Poo.
I guess not. So I guess this sort of ends our little video tour of our great house. We're so happy
no,
to be
it
here.
Doesn't.
And
it doesn't end it.
Okay, this
never.
Doesn't end it.
Absolutely.
Here's, this is what it, this is, Aunt Jill wanted me to show you this, Tali. I'm going to zoom in on her favorite thing. It's the back of him, but where'd it go? It's the troll. It's our little friend, the troll. You can only see the back of him.
Protects our house.
But he's our little protector, and then we'll get a front view of him in a second. All right. More bits of furniture for Heidi. We have courtesy of my grandparents, and actually that's 95% of the stuff in this house, thankfully. This is one piece of furniture, and going over there. Shouldn't she be asleep on the dog's bed? And Grandpa's old chair. Grandpa's old piece of furniture. And Mimi. And then the dog bed. All right, we're gonna go outside now. A little tour of the outside, so going out the front door.
We have the security lock that doesn't do anything right now, or no one knows what it does. We find the take away out here.
Just
didn't
tell Tyler.
Okay, go ahead.
Here's our key thing. Such a key.
We're still not sure what that means yet. I don't know if this was like a country club or something before, but maybe one day we'll figure out. Oh, our mezuzah. There's a couple mezuzahs. One is right there. That's from my parents. They got that in Italy or something like that. And...
Hello?
What'd you just do there?
I rang.
Oh, okay. And over here... Okay. Ty, you leading the way?
And there's the official American flag. And we're gonna come here for a minute. Oh, we got the troll.
Ooh, the troll. Let's see the troll.
Waiting for you, I got Pepper to sit.
All right. Isn't that a great troll?
No.
Aunt Jill doesn't like the troll, but
she's,
I like it.
She's gonna replace it with a dog saying welcome.
Yes. Hey.
So Tyler's there at one side of the...
Walking.
That's not a good thing, Pepper. You're
it's
not going to like
that. Almost like when Pepper got the gorg.
Pepper.
Pepper. Well, it's not Halloween.
That's true.
We're slowly finding Pepper likes all sorts of things, like gourds, pumpkins, bird food, deer droppings, rabbit droppings, and anything
and
else we don't want her to
them,
eat.
And she does something that you might not want to know. Bark!
Shh!
Where'd you...
She found her
toy. Oh, that's her bone. That's
like it.
Hey, is that the one from last night?
So, there's another blue jay. The blue jays are out today. Got a nice little view out there. Get some nice colored leaves, although they're looking rather similar today. They're usually very different. And you can't see too much in the water because it's usually a bit cloudy, but believe me when I tell you there are fish in there. Some algae eaters that are about 3 foot long, some bass, smallmouth bass, and some sunnies.
You'll be able to see the fish.
But when Tali, when you come, you can feed them.
You'll be able to see the fish, and then because Tyler's getting food.
And Tyler's over at the future, well, that's our barn, which will become a future, hopefully, studio of some sort. Maybe recording or music or pottery, or maybe we'll stick a horse in there. Because, you know, Tali, your grandfather loves horses, and he wants his daughter to have a horse. So maybe one day we'll have a horse in there. Because Sisson Wines are known to be horse lovers. That's right from his mouth.
Videoing?
I was saying how one day they probably have a horse there.
Is that what you
said? And we're going to do a little fish feeding, and Pepper's eating the pumpkin again.
She's just putting it back where she found it.
Such a smart dog.
Oh, maybe she's not. Okay, let's feed her.
Yeah, Bri, if she starts to like try to eat that thing, we should probably take that from her.
Okay.
And give her her bone back.
She's trying to eat it. What do I do?
See, you think any fish will come?
What should I do? She's trying to eat it.
I take it from her and put the bone back in her mouth, so that's like a good thing. No, don't play with it. Grab it. Grab the pumpkin. Jill.
Yep.
Okay, there's no fish coming yet, Tali.
Yeah.
Maybe they're, you know, we've never fed them in the morning. Maybe they're sleeping.
Oh, that's trying to keep the food off in the lake. In the river. I'm just gonna take one more handful.
Yeah, but then she's gonna eat it when you're not looking. Well, this is a new experience here. They usually come right away. I think they're afternoon fish. I think they're just not morning fish.
Should I throw them also towards the middle so they see lots of food?
No.
Okay, we'll sign in. We'll talk to you later.
This is a video that never ends. It just goes on and on. My friends, some people started seeing it, not knowing what it was. But then they started seeing it forever just because this is the video that never ends. It just goes on and on. People started seeing it, not knowing what it was, and then they started watching it forever just because this is a song that doesn't end. It just goes on and on. My friends, some people started singing it, not knowing what it was, and then they started singing it forever just because this is the song that never ends. It just goes on and on, my friends. Some people started singing it, but never thought it was. And then they started singing it forever just because it's a song that never ends. It's a song that never ends. It just goes on and on, my friends. People started singing it, but not knowing what it was. And they started singing it forever just because it's a song that never ends. Goes on and on. My friends, they were singing it, not knowing what it was, and then they started singing it forever
I'm singing. I know. It gets on everybody's nerves. Everybody's nerves. Everybody's nerves. It's just a song that never ends. It just goes on. My friends, people started singing it, not knowing what it was. And then they started singing it forever. This is the song that never ends.
Guys. It's a song that never ends.
Yay! Wait, Pepper's eating. Taking a nap after a long tour.
After a long day of hard videoing.
Say goodbye, Pepper. Pepper. Bye,
Pepper.
Peppy.
And whoever knew that pancake man.
Goodbye. And the pancake man, one day, hopefully I'll get to meet him. I'm sure he says goodbye, too. Bye-bye. Yeah.
Thanksgiving 2001.
Yay!
Mike, you're throwing the white ball.
Do they want her in?
Keep her in, Bri.
Yeah, keep her in. Yay!
Throw it far.
I can't.
Hey, who's that? Do you know who that is?
You got a little haircut.
Hi, Pepper. Happy Thanksgiving.
Make sure you don't get any turkey or anything. Say happy
Thanksgiving. Woof! Ian is helping to eat the food.
He's a taste tester. He's got to taste the spinach dip. He's tasting that. Ryan doesn't fall over. We know it's okay. Right? If I need to be able to see Here, you want to get a video of turkey?
That's good. I was just going to say that. Jill's first turkey.
Wait, oh, I covered it. Okay.
Let's
see it. Let's look at the turkey.
Ready, Bri? Ready to ooh and ah? Ooh. Ah, Jill's first turkey. Very impressive.
For a little while.
We'll get the feedback later when we actually taste it.
If it's frozen in the center.
The master carver at work.
Yeah. Might not ever be allowed to do this one again.
I like how he puts his hips into it.
Jill's going to be carving from 2002
on. I don't think that he can do it this year.
Okay, Scott, we try to keep him under half an inch thick.
Thanksgiving.
I'm so glad to meet you.
It's a pen in a minute.
It's carcass.
Yeah. You want a carcass in your carcass? Leave the chef alone.
I just want to make a quick toast. Just because it's Thanksgiving, I just want to toast to every single person in this room that I give thanks to. Because I'm very thankful for every single one of you. There's not one person here that I'm not thankful for when I think about when I look around the table. And I'm thankful for every single thing that we have, Scott and I, and I'm thankful for Scott.
Cheers.
Just drink to everybody in the room.
And I'd like to say, ditto. And, I guess guess on a more of a serious note, I was hoping we could just take a moment of silence for those that lost their lives on September 11th. And anybody that we know that's out there helping protect our country now and enabling us to have the freedom that we do. And maybe we all could pause for a moment of silence on that. And we'd like to just have a toast for all of you being here, and hopefully have many more.
Cheers.
And I too would like to say how grateful I am to be at Jill and Scott's beautiful home. Jill hasn't made too many dinners for me.
Saving it all up for this one.
So I'm thrilled to be here. We are very excited with our new family, the Burgers, and we're just very, very grateful for you. I'm grateful to be here for all of you.
And of all the people that I said we're thankful for, we're also just, we happen to be missing Joel, Heidi, and Talia, so we're thankful for them.
Yeah, it's on the record, too.
We miss Joel, Heidi, and Talia tonight.
Everybody say hi to them.
Are you thankful to Uncle Scott? Are you thankful for something?
Yep.
Hey, Mike, Brian, Michael, you want to add something for the video?
That's right, we all want to add
Michael.
What we're
Tyler
thankful
and Sarah
for.
Scott.
Well,
you
want to
show us what you
turkey.
Made?
I'm thankful for it because we killed it and it might be sad. And I'm thankful for the seagulls. And I'm thankful this one.
Feeding her baby with a ladle as the broad-brimmed Christian, which is angel, socks. Oh, the scissors. Let's see who's in socks.
Yeah, I'll make it. What do you have to do with
it? What do you think about this new house? Well, wait. With this doorbell. And can you show them this remarkable phone? I'll call Talia.
Wait, I'm gonna come look inside.
Now, if you'll come and look
open the window. Open the window, Ty.
Wait, we're
filming the
phone.
Oh, okay.
Wait, where's the phone? Okay, now we're gonna take a look inside the house.
Oh, the phone's missing.
Me? This alarm system is installed. Hi.
No, don't do anything.
Well, that might be a repeater.
Oops, okay. This is our oven set.
No. Talia, what do you think about the new house?
Good.
Do you call a lot of people on your phone?
Yeah.
Hell, let's call someone right now. Can I show the phone? Hey, Talia.
Hello,
Ty. Yeah, Ty, this is the show the phone kind
of hello. Wait.
Here we go.
Hello, bye.
Okay. And, oh, by the way, do you have a pet perfect dog door? Built in a beautiful clock, roof, beautiful clock, nice roof,
and a beautiful kitchen.
And if you look in over to the side, we have a radio, a clock, tree, TV, lights,
and a
are you the puppy?
This is our dog, and he comes through our dog door. Door has two parts. One, window, and two, mail slot. And these windows are beautiful. What do you have to say about your new house, Falcon?
Good. Good.
And she loves it.
Voted brother-in-laws.
We are Groot.
Yeah, forget about the whiskey. Where's whiskey? This is a new name.
So we brew bedroom.
It's like Charlie the Chocolate Factory.
It's not time to make a change.
Oh, I love that song.
Just relax. Take it easy.
I love that
thing. Who knows once he had some facts?
Oh, I don't know.
You know, I've ever seen George Harrison die, that nice.
It's just
the
Here, I was going to play this one time or so.
It's massive.
Here.
Joey can play it? Yay, Joey!
Right out of bed.
We call him the closet guitarist.
Here we go, one more time.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to Grandpa. Happy birthday to you.
Now wait a minute.
Hold on.
Hold on, we weren't able to.
Opening your first two presents. So you need to show us.
We'll get this in a minute. Are you done now? All right, now I need my last song from Michael and Tali. Nice, their best song. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you.
Okay, you start on this end. Come on. Whoa. Relaxing golf and no toys, Michael. No toys.
You might consider that a toy.
Oh, painting clothes.
Wait.
Oh, professional painter's pants.
I never had them.
Whoa, I'm all set.
That's great.
I'm all set. This is coolness. Wait till I walk in Home Depot with these. Whoa.
Hello, it's your birthday.
Having you all is my birthday.
Yay. Having me was his birthday.
Everyone is switching the furniture to prepare for painting the baby's room. The double bed is moving upstairs. 10 o'clock at night. And Tali and Michael are very tired, and we're keeping them awake.
No, they sound like they're flying. They're singing and dancing.
Hey, you guys have any words for the camera?
Yeah. There's enough cooks in the kitchen.
Yeah, you can go down and have ice cream with Barry downstairs.
I'm just calling this good, clean, and entertaining. Wait, guys, everyone up, out of the way.
Yeah, Scott, can you move them all out of the way?
Everyone up, out of the way.
I don't want to. I'd rather have the mattress on the floor than to have a chair. Okay.
Let's do that.
Just
push from the bottom and start with the mattress.
Look, and they shut your butt, Joe.
Come on, girls and boys.
Can you guys sing me a song?
Happy birthday to Grandpa. Happy birthday to Grandpa.
Don't move it.
Goodbye.
Michael. Reasoning with trains.
Leaving.
Hey!
5-year-olds with trains.
Let's do a train check! The one time I had my train, I did like a train. I was in my train driving, and I didn't like a train. I watched my movie so far. I loved you. So we have a trick, and everybody has to do it together.
Okay.
So let's all hold hands and get in a circle.
No. Zach, get in our circle. Zach, hold Michael's hand.
Okay. We have to go around a lot of time, very fast, while always saying happy birthday to myself.
That sounds fun.
Okay. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Happy
birthday to myself.
No, to me.
To Michael. Happy birthday to you.
Here we go, we're cutting our pizza!
Zachary could do it. Zachary, can you do it? Okay, take all of them and pass them to him. Good job. Okay, on the count of three, we're going to sing really loud, guys, okay? One,
what else are you good at?
I'm good at art.
Yeah.
Sometimes, and I'm good at doing stuff. Like, cause I'm really good at helping, and that's what I want
to
do.
What's your favorite thing to do?
Do art. Art.
Can you sing me one of your songs from school?
Which one?
Friends?
Okay.
Move back a little bit so I can see you.
Okay. Friends, like your sister and brother, friends, like the ups and downs, it's great, friends around, friends, like your sister and brother, friends, like the ups and downs, it's great, friends around, friends. Now can I skip a part to the harder part?
Sure.
Okay. Yeah. If I feel down, I can talk to a friend. Now should I skip one more part?
Sure.
Thanks. We're all fishing the pond. We all swim together and help each other along. Friends, like a sister and brother, friends. Like the ups and downs, it's great having friends around. And friends, it's great having friends. It's great having friends.
Wow, what a beginning.
to a store. Can you believe it? You see, life was really great for our hero, James Henry Trotter, until this happened to his parents. He was sent away to live with his two aunts, Aunt Sponge and Aunt Spiker. They were selfish and lazy and cruel, and right from the beginning they started beating poor old James for almost no reason at all. And his room was as bare as a prison cell. They lived on the top of the high hill in the south of England. The hill was so high that from almost anywhere in the garden, James could look down and see for miles and miles across the marvelous landscape. And on a very clear day, if he looked in the right direction, he could see a tiny gray dot far on the horizon, which was the house he used to live in with his beloved mother and father.
And just beyond that, he could see the sea itself. And then there came a morning when something rather peculiar happened to him. It all started on a blazing hot day in the middle of the summer. Aunt Sponge and Aunt Spiker were sitting nearby, sipping tall glasses of fizzy lemonade and watching him to make sure he didn't stop work for 1 minute. Let's take a close look at what's happening.
Wait a minute, they're... Why?
carving up the wood first. Be off with your wood, you hideous brat. It doesn't work.
Will it ever stop growing?
Will it ever stop growing? Get away from the tree trunk, you stupid boy! This light is shaking and it will fall off and break. Then that's the branch is bending right down. But I can't believe it, the branches are breaking. Hallelujah! What a pitch! Typical magnificent and difficult. And what a meal. It's right. It's just perfect. Now see here, Spiker. Why don't we go and get ourselves a shovel and dig a great big hunk of it for you and me? No, not yet. But I can't wait to eat some.
My dear Sponge.
What? There's a pile of money to be made out of this. If only we can handle it right. Wait and see.
You would probably be scared too if you were out alone on a dark, quiet night. Well, this is where James knows. He can just feel it in his bones. It's something stranger than ever this time is about to happen. He's sure of it. He can feel it coming.
so different. Suddenly the whole place seems to be alive with magic. Wow, it feels so warm. It's a little furry, like the skin of a baby mouse.
What's that?
I don't believe it. There's a hole inside of it. Quite a large hole. Certain things animals about the size of the box. This isn't just a hole. It's a tunnel. Boy, it really is damp and murky in here. The walls are wet and sticky, and it tastes like peach juice dripping from the ceiling.
Delicious.
Now it's going uphill, in the very center. Ouch! What's that? It seems like a solid wall. It feels like wood, except that it's very jagged, full of deep grooves. Good grief, I know what this is. I've come to the stone in the middle of the peach. And here. What appeared? A small door crushes the face of the stone. Let's see now. There. Swing open. What's this like?
Look, you'll see it.
We've been waiting for you.
Oh, no. No.
I'm hungry.
I'm famished.
So am I. Everyone's famished. We need food.
Aren't you hungry?
What's the matter? You look positively ill.
He looks as though he's going to faint any second.
Oh my goodness, the poor thing. I do believe he thinks it's him that we are wanting to meet.
Oh dear, what an awful thought.
You mustn't be frightened. We weren't dreaming hurting you. You're one of us now, didn't you know that? You're one of the crew. We are all in the same boat.
We thought you were never going to turn up. Glad you made it.
So cheer up, my boy. And while you are here, please come over and help me take off my boots. It takes me hours to get them off all by myself. Thank you very much. You are so kind.
Well, you have a lot of boots.
I have a lot of legs and a lot of feet. 100 to be exact. I'm a centipede, you know.
There he goes again. He simply cannot stop telling lies about his legs. He's only got 42. The trouble is that most people don't bother to count them. There's nothing marvelous, you know, centipede, about having a lot of legs.
Poor earthworm. He's blind, you know. He can't see how splendid I look.
In my opinion, the really marvelous thing is to have no legs at all and to be able to walk just the same.
You call that walking? You're a slither. That's all you are. You just slither along.
I block.
You're a pest.
I am not a pest. I am a useful and muscular creature. Ask any garden you like, and ask for you.
I am a pest.
He is so proud of that, though for the life of me, I cannot understand why. Oh, please excuse me. My name is Ladybug.
Pleased to meet. I'm the only pest in this room, unless you count old green grasshopper over there. But he's too old to be a pest anymore.
Yep, so I'm a grasshopper. I'm old, but not a pest. I'm a musician.
Well said, old green grasshopper. It's easy to have a pest right now. Mine is a spider. James! Your name is James, isn't it?
Yes.
Well, James, have you ever wanted your life seen such a marvelous, colossal centipede as me?
I certainly haven't. How on earth did you to be like that?
Very peculiar. Very, very peculiar indeed. I was messing about in the garden under the old peach tree when suddenly a funny little green thing came wiggling past.
snow. And whenever he catches a cold, which he dreads, we'll have 49 noses to blow.
Achoo!
We may see a dragon and nobody knows, then we won't see a unicorn there. We may see a terrible monster with toes growing out of the tufts of his hair.
Woo-hoo!
We may see a sweet little bitty bright hen, so playful, so kind and well-bred. And such beautiful eggs, you'd spoil them and then they explode and they blow off your head.
Kaboom!
But who cares?
Let us go from this horrible hill. Let us roll, let us bowl, let us plunge. Let's go rolling and bowling and spinning until we're away from old Spiker and Sponge.
Yes.